Welcome to Mastering Solutions. This interacting objects question says that blocks with masses of 1, 2, and 3 kilograms are lined up in a row on a frictionless table, and all three are pushed forward by a 12 newton force applied to the 1 kilogram block. How much force does the 2 kilogram block exert on A, the 3 kilogram block, and B, the 1 kilogram block? So let's draw a picture here. So we have the 1 kilogram block right there, and then we'll say this one a little bit bigger is the 2, and then the 3. So 1 kilogram, 2, and 3. So right here, we have a force, and they say that it's 12 newtons applied to block 1. And then we need to figure out for block 2, what the force is pushing back on 1, and then pushing forward on 3. So the challenge with this problem really is just the organization aspect of it, because it can get really confusing keeping track of which arrows, which force vectors represent which block and where it's going and everything. So we need to be really careful about labeling all this. So when we look at this, let's figure out the acceleration first off. So we'll use the force equation, force is equal to ma, and we'll divide both sides by the mass to isolate the acceleration. So acceleration, of course, is equal to force divided by the mass. Now we know that the force is 12 newtons. So we have 12 newtons divided by the total mass, because they're all connected as one big unit as they're sliding across this frictionless table. So we have 1 kg plus 2 kg plus 3 kgs. So 6 total. And so 12 divided by 6 is going to be 2 meters per second squared. So now we have the acceleration for the blocks. Next, we need to figure out what the force is for 2 on 3. I drew 3 coordinate grids here so that we can do the free body diagrams for all of them. So we have free body diagram for 1, 2, and 3. All of them will have a normal going up and a weight going down. So we have normal, normal, and normal, and then weight coming down. You could draw the weight progressively and the normal progressively bigger on 2 and 3 if you wanted. I didn't for mine, but you get the idea that obviously they weigh more for 2 and 3. So now for block 1, we have the force right here. So we'll just label that as F for the main force. And that is the force on block 1 pushing it forward. But block 2 is pushing it backwards. So we have a force here of 2 on 1. Now for block 2, obviously we have the force of block 1 pushing block 2 forward. But then we have block 3 pushing back, so we have 3 on 2. And then lastly, for block 3, all that we have is we have the force of the second block, 2 on 3, pushing it forward. So you can see here how this could get confusing pretty quickly. So like I said, organization really helps out here quite a bit. For part A, we need to figure out the force of 2 on 3. So we need to figure out this guy right here. To do that, we'll use the force is equal to ma equation again. So the force is equal to the mass, and it's going to be 3 kilograms, because we're using the 3 kilogram block because 2 is pushing this one forward. So we're just looking at this mass there. And we have the acceleration of 2 meters per second squared. So the force of 2 on 3 is 6 newtons. So that is the answer for part A. Now part B is a little bit trickier, not too bad though. So let's come down here. So for B, we need to figure out the force of 2 on 1. So we need this force vector right there. For this one, we need to sum the forces in the x direction. So sum of the forces in the x. So we have the force on 1, so right here. And then we're going to subtract from that 2 on 1. So those are really the only forces in the x direction right there. So 2 on 1. And that is equal to m1 times a, because it is accelerating, so it's not in equilibrium. So we have mass of the first block times the acceleration. we're trying to solve for this right here. So we'll subtract over the force on one to the other side. So we have negative force of 2 on 1 is equal to m1a minus the force on 1. Now let's multiply everything by negative 1. So we're basically just changing the sign of everything. So the positive force of 2 on 1, because this is what we needed, the negative, it would give you an incorrect answer, is going to be a positive force on 1 minus m1 times acceleration. And so the last step to plug in our numbers here, we already know that force on 1 is 12 newtons. It was given in the problem, and we'll subtract from it the mass of the first block, which is 1 kilogram, times the acceleration of 2 meters per second squared, of course. So this is just 2. So 12 newtons minus 2 newtons gives us 10. So the answer for part B of the force of 2 on 1 is 10 newtons.